Thank you so very much to join Mostafa and I in this conversation. We just signed a deal, but it's not more than a deal. It's about a conversation about that we all had in the last 2-3 years. And what was the conversation in the world is that we have a food crisis and we have fertilizer crisis at the same time due to the Russian invasion of Ukraine. And that was raised a certain number of questions. How a continent like Africa, which has so much land, which has such a large agricultural potential, is still struggling with food supply. How come Africa cannot export more of, not only produce more for its own citizens, but produce more? How come Africa is the last continent which didn't have its green revolution? Those are the questions that Mostafa has been asking himself for many years, and we are asking also ourselves, and we say. The second question is that when the world is trying to green, to increase production, agricultural production, the world isn't really thinking about two or three things. One of them is to have enough supply, but to reduce waste at the same time. To have enough food for people, you need to reduce waste, because waste is creating methane, it's creating a lot of things which are not good for environment. The second is, how can we produce fertilizers? Because we believe that it's important to have fertilizers. We are not among those who believe that we don't need fertilizers, but to do it in a sustainable way and in a green way. The third one is, can we ensure that nobody is left behind, particularly the smallholders? So this is all these questions that Mostafa will tell us about today. How do you see agriculture in the world, and what do you see fertilizers?
I need this? Well, first, thanks for having me, Makhtar, and thank you for your great leadership at IFC, and we're very proud to have an African and a true African heading that very important institution. The vision is really, first, facts that underlie the vision. You mentioned the role of fertilizer. 50% of food production, of agricultural production, is due to the use of fertilizer. So that is a fact that is not well known, but it is a fact. The other fact is arable land per capita worldwide is decreasing worryingly. And that's simply because population growth and most of the usable arable land has been used, except in Africa. So Africa still holds 60% of the unused arable land worldwide is in Africa. So you see that the big picture is that we have, in terms of mindset, to start thinking of Africa not just as the locus of food security problems that we have to address very quickly, but we should think of Africa as also as a solution worldwide in terms of food security. Africa will necessarily, because of what the facts I mentioned, contribute to feed the rest of the world. And you mentioned the Green Revolution. Any Green Revolution, whether India or other places, has started with fertilizers. Simply because fertilizer increase productivity, and because of that, they avoid extensive agriculture, which uses too much land, deforestation, and so on and so forth. So the reasoned use of fertilizer, and arguably they've been overused in some places, but if Africa embarks on the right type of fertilizer use, then I think we can be optimistic about what can happen. I can tell you what that is, but just to finish on the fact that, and you asked why is this case in terms of food and agricultural trade and flows, the natural resources used that one needs to produce nutrients and fertilizer are abundant in Africa. Africa holds more than 90% of world reserves of phosphate to produce phosphate-based fertilizer. Nitrogen is an important input in fertilizer, and that comes at this stage from natural gas. And Africa has abundant resources in natural gas. Yet it's at this stage mostly exporting these natural resources to produce, to have fertilizers produced elsewhere and then imported in Africa. If Africa could produce its own fertilizer, then it will also have the possibility to customize and to produce the right fertilizer for its needs, and not import the standard fertilizer, but be able to customize the fertilizer to it for its needs, with tremendous impact, positive impact on the environment, for example.
The knowledge that you have developed is used for the small farmers. You are very proud of it, and telling that we need to have tailored solutions for the farmers. So tell me a little bit about these two questions. Your journey to become one of the leaders in the world, coming from Africa, and you are very proud African, because we repeat it every time. Secondly, how did you never forget the small farmers and smallholders?
Africa could use and develop its own fertilization policy. It doesn't have to use the same fertilizers that others is using, and certainly not to the same amount and same quantity. Africa, and there are technologies for that, we can talk about them, digital and others. I know, you know, entrepreneurs in Africa are developing AI solutions. These are critical to do the right customization, etc. Data. So let's leapfrog and produce our own fertilizers in Africa that are adapted to our own needs, and they will be more productive, cheaper, and with much less environmental degradation, simply because it will be adapted and making sure that the soil and the plant fully absorbs their nutrients and they don't leach in the water table, for example.
We have a lot of conversation about today, this week, about mobilization, about financing climate change, about financing a global public good. This is what we're talking about. For me, the effort of IFC is to support vision like this, to be able to link many things. Climate change, particularly the adaptation part of it, but also the mitigation part, has been mentioned. Poverty reduction, job creation, economic transformation of the frontier markets. So this is what IFC 3.0 is about. And we would like to have an ambition which is expanded in the area, because food production, for me, is a pillar of what we would like to do. Is that we would like to work towards having more irrigated land in the continent. If you look at the Sahel, around the large rivers that you have in the Sahel, being the Niger River or the Senegal River, if you look at the irrigated land around that, there is much more which can be done. Country needs money, private sector needs to invest in it. So we would like to mobilize more of it. But with having a major input like fertilizer, which is produced in a way which is adapted to the reality of low-income countries, but also in a sustainable way, we are building the supply chains that will allow this continent in Africa to be a net exporter of food and not anymore imported. And that story is a story that we have seen in other parts of the world. Since OCP is also a global player, it will help countries which don't have a problem of food supply, but have an agricultural system which are not green enough to become progressively greener, greener, and greener. So the reason why we are building this partnership with OCP, which is not a project financing, it goes far beyond project financing. It's about a vision and an ability to demonstrate to investors in the capital market that there are many reasons, if you want to do impact investing, to go and invest in agriculture in Africa. So thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Makhtar. Thank you.